odd shaped, and so they're not well attached.
I'm looking at the screen here. Is that 500 nanometers?
Yeah.
Wow.
So we're about 100,000 times.
Okay.
This is the problem you run up against. You know, you ask me how high we can magnify and turn off this remote. So we can get higher magnifications, we just can't necessarily.
They're not as clear.
See things in them. So I'm slowing down the scan rate. So you can see the scan bars going by as the scan rate slows down. You know, you're getting better signal to noise.
It's starting to come clearer.
But you may not necessarily have structure there that's going to lend itself to analysis.
It came back as carbon?
No, you told me this was carbon material. And so what might be useful to drop the accelerating voltage lower?
Wow, look at that. Wow, look at the top ones, how they have a translucency appearance to them. It's like a folded up ball of silk.
Mm-hmm. drop the accelerating voltage lower, and what happens is when you have your sample interacting with the electron beam,
it bounces back an erratic picture.
No, you have to view this like a
no problem.
When the beam hits the surface of the sample, it penetrates below the surface. And it penetrates.
Oh, right there. Look at that.
In a.
That is clean.
In a teardrop. And the higher the accelerating voltage, the deeper into the sample your beam penetrates, and the deeper below the surface you're getting detail. And the size of that interaction volume varies with your accelerating voltage, which is the speed of the electrons coming down the column.
Okay.
And the composition of the material. So for a constant lump of something, if you hit it with a lower accelerating voltage versus a higher accelerating voltage, the lower voltage will penetrate into that material less than the higher accelerating voltage.
Well, that makes a lot of sense to what you explained to me earlier. And remember, I'm new to this, but right now it looks like we're at 3 kilovolts and we're getting a clearer image, but we're at 10,000 kilovolts or 10,000 volts and we were at a difficult image.
Well, if we were trying to do chemical composition of the sample and it was a multi-layered sample, a very thin film multi-layered sandwich, you could potentially, by slowly increasing the accelerating voltage and taking data points for each of those voltages, you could potentially determine what the different layers were, because at the lower accelerating voltages, you wouldn't see deeply into the sample. And as you increased it, you would be penetrating deeper and deeper. So an alternative way to describe the effect is if you had a very thin layer of grease on the surface of the sample, at higher accelerating voltages, your beam would just whistle right through it, and you wouldn't see any evidence of it. And at lower accelerating voltages, it stands out quite clearly. And so that was those were some of the images you were looking at in that handout out in the other lab.
Okay.
And I can give you the web address of that paper describing that.
Oh, that's pretty.
It's artistic. I'm not sure what it's telling us.
It doesn't appear that there's mixed elements in there, even though it's hard to tell from this. Everything looks like it's just the same thing in a different shape, but not a different elemental form.
This is only going to tell us morphology.
Yeah.
So it, this charge buildup, all of this here, there's all this brightness.
Okay.
And some of these wavy lines and things would also be...
There is a conductivity to the material, so... makes sense. We're at 2 angstroms now?
That scale bar is 2 angstroms.
Oh, that the width of that bar is showing 2 angstroms.
That's end to end.
Okay.
See, the image is moving, that's why it's blurring. Because we're doing frame averaging here to try to reduce the noise.
Yes.
Let's go grab a quick look at that other sample.
Okay, great. That, thank you for that. That's.
Did you bring a thumb drive?
For me, it's conclusive that it's a homogeneous sample.